All right. Good evening, good morning, wherever you are, down under, up north. This is the Meek Informant. We are back. And I am joined today with my opponent. My opponent, please step in and tell us who you are.
Yo, what up, YouTube? It's your boy, Dice of Death. That's twitch.tv/DiceOrDeath, a.k.a. the Ray Dog, a.k.a. Asawa Raydaka.
Whoa, 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 whoa. We only reserve this moment for our Patreons. And let me just tell you right now, we have some really cool Patreons right now. We got Midgard Games coming in as one of our first sponsors. Secondary, though, to Luxury Playstyle. I don't know, Ray, have you seen those Luxury Playstyle tokens before?
I've seen them at every single tournament I've ever been to. Very sexy.
That's because everyone keeps on using Lux Informant for 15% off at luxplay.com. Another one of our really, really amazing fans and sponsors, Luxury Playstyle. So what are we doing today? I think we're going to play a little bit of a Jigoku League game for the New England L5R Season 2 Top 8. So this is our first round for everybody, and I think only one round one game has already been played at this moment. So it is currently, what, July 6th? What day is it, Ray?
It's
help me.
July 17th.
17th, all right. So we're actually pretty ahead of the game here, you and I, trying to get this done, because no other games have been done yet. But a cool thing about this format is obviously we're top eight, so we get open deck lists. We submitted them last week, and right now we're going to take a look at them. But first, I'm going to go ahead and throw up on the screen what the brackets are. So, you know, in New England L5R, they do a lot of really great things, but they do not do brackets well, as we have seen on their Chicken Scratch, if you're on the Discord. So I went ahead and took all of, I don't know, 30 seconds to create a challenge, whatever that website is called. Bracket.
Yeah.
And,
going above and beyond.
Oh yeah, I mean, no, this is a standard. You guys over there at the L5R are just like below. But right,
hey, I
you,
don't run the standard.
I know, right? You would do a challenge. I know you would.
Yeah, Dice or Death is a separate entity from any L5R.
Oh yeah. No, I'm not talking to you. I'm talking to them when I say you guys. I'm talking to them. All right. So, anyways, I don't know that these seeds are correct, but we're gonna go ahead and talk through this. So Devin and Derek already played. Derek won. I think Derek's running Lion, right? I'm pretty sure, right, Derek?
That is correct. Yeah.
I don't know if Devin was running his Unicorn or his Crane. Do you know? I think it was probably Unicorn, right?
Let's see. I have his deck list here. He is... One second. He was playing Unicorn, yeah.
Unicorn, okay. Well, that's too bad to see, because I would have loved to see Unicorn go for it. But, hey, Lion is Lion. Next, we have Josh, R, and Nick. And Josh is from just outside of New England, so he is a transplant. But I think he's playing Scorpion KB, and he has come to quite a few of our events, or at least one of our events in New England. So him and Nick will have a really fun game that I look forward to seeing. I think they're playing tomorrow night, and I think Nick is going to try and do a similar thing. So we're gonna see the results of that. And whoever wins that will be facing off against Derek in the semifinals. And then we come to the main event, you and me, buddy, right? We played this past weekend together. Did we have a good time?
Yeah, I had a good time. I don't know if you had so much of a good time, but you were playing a non-standard deck for yourself.
It was a standard deck, but it was Unicorn, and I literally was handed the deck moments before, and not looking through it at all, I went ahead and trounced your wife with her old clan. Oh, boom! Is she there to hear that?
Wow, shots fired. She did not hear that, thankfully.
I had fun playing the Unicorn deck. It was pretty fun, but I guess I got a little sneak peek of what you're playing tonight, and we're going to look at those in a moment, right?
I think it was. I was playing the exact same list that I brought to the tournament. So,
what do they call that? Good Stuff Phoenix? Is that what it's called?
Yeah. It's a little bit of Jade Throne influence. I'm kind of experimenting a little bit for Gen Con.
Nice.
I don't know.
Oh, so if you're at Gen Con, how have people come find you?
People can find me at Gen Con by finding my hat, I guess. That's probably going to be the most recognizable way
and
pick me out of a crowd.
You need to describe your hat, though. People are not looking at your hat right now.
I mean, it's the Tadaka hat, right? Like, I don't even know what they're called. It's like the big conical, like...
It's the Elemental Master woven hat, apparently.
Yeah, exactly.
All right, cool. Are you doing... It's all one day at Gen Con this year, right?
No, it's 2 days.
It's 2 days, but isn't all the qualifier on one day? Like all the qualifiers on one day?
Yeah, correct. Cool. And I'm doing a skirmish pod the day before that, so.
Cool. Well, that's going to be fun. I went last year. I had a blast, so you'll have good time.
Looking forward to it.
And then last but definitely not least, we have Eric and Kyle. And I assume Eric's playing Scorpion. I don't know what Kyle's on these days. No idea.
Kyle's been on Unicorn for a while.
Oh, okay. Well, there we go. We'll
I think he actually took the top Unicorn in the group stage.
Cool. All right. So that was brief. Let's go on to the next thing here. Let's talk about whatever the next tab I have in my window is. It is your deck. All right. This is the first time I'm looking at it. It is the classic Kaiden Asawa with a very, very spicy three let go Dragon Splash and two Ancient Master. Where did you come up with this idea, Ray?
Pretty much, it's something that I came up with. I don't think anybody's really been going with the three let go three Ancient Master. But it's important for favor control. So that's a secret spicy tech you might not have heard of.
Yeah. That's a good meta call there. I like it.
Yeah.
Cool. Yeah. Like in here, for me, I pretty much probably didn't look at your deck because I just assumed it was like pretty much this.
Yeah.
But it's important for me to know. Like, I guess, Ancient Master is a card. Don't forget that, Adam. I'm talking to, future Adam. Path of Man. You like rocked it with Path of Man against me on this weekend. So that how's that been working for you?
It's hit or miss. But when it hits, it really hits. It's nice to get free money.
Mm-hmm. Let's see what else. So you're going 12 holdings. Is that standard? Is that standard Phoenix right now? Or are you gonna kind of just because there's so many great holdings? You're like, I want them all.
No, Phoenix is actually running a lot of holdings these days. I think part of it is that you can survive a bad dynasty flop because you've got, you can get so much work done with your unbows and your stay not bows that you can kind of be okay with not playing a big character for a turn if you happen to get bad flop. Ancestral Shrine helps with Dishonor stuff.
Yeah.
And sometimes you can get off a double tap with Ugina, so that's fun.
Oh yeah, yeah, that's
claim the void, return the void, claim it again.
That's really hot. I like that. Yeah.
Yeah.
One off Kudaka. So is that just to flush things out?
Yeah. I dropped a Tsuki for her. You'll notice I'm not running Prodigy of the Waves, and I didn't just slot in Kudaka. Because I'm running Bustling Academy, I have these naive students that are kind of taking up space. Mm-hmm. So if I drop Bustling, which I might before Gen Con, I would go up to 3 Kudaka instead and just live my life that way. It's just I like Kudaka, it's good and my deck is tight, so I just ended up slotting one in there
for sure. Cool. Yeah, so looks like this is basically go as fast as you can Phoenix and put on the brakes if you see anything with Dishonor and look for those Ancestral Shrines. And Tadaka comes into play pretty much rock and roll.
Yep.
Yeah.
Exactly.
Yeah, cool. Let's see. I think I have mine up now. I don't know if you have a link to mine to look at it, but...
Yeah, I have it up here.
I am running a Scorpion, City of the Open Hand. This is the shift to Keeper, which I've been running since I think we got the roll. I built the deck... And then I got some input from people, and this has been like an amalgamation of that over that time. I tested Tattered Missive, so if you look, that's in here, and I've been playing on Jugoku a little bit with this, and like people are like, oh my gosh, that's really cool. I'm like, yeah, but it's really not that great. I still don't love it. Like,
it's an interesting choice.
It is. Sure. I watched Brandon at the Midgard EC go ahead and use it, and like because it really blew up and worked well for him, I was like, okay, I gotta give it another try. So this is my attempt at using it again. But we'll see how it goes. Like it's a really weird card and
I like the two all and nothing. Is that a common thing Dishonor Scorpion these days?
Oh my god, that card is so good. So people keep on saying to take it out, and then like I was at the store yesterday playing and I ran that card and Casey was sitting there and she was like, oh, everyone tells me to take this card out, and she's a Phoenix player, right? And I was like, well, yeah, it's really good. And she's like, why? I'm like, well, when you display a power, the Void Ring on somebody, and you just resolve the Air Ring? That's really fun. And she's like, wait, you can do that? I was like, yes, and you get a card. She's like, oh my god, that is amazing. So that's why All or Nothing is in there. I've tested it. I tested like not running two of them and running the Seeker of Knowledge and things like that. But like that's so circumstantial. Like you're like telegraphing things. This is like just a good card. Whether you want to use it or not, you can cycle it out. But like most times, you end up using it and then getting a card right back. And this deck, this deck just needs cards. Like
it's absolutely a good card. I think in Phoenix it gets edged out because Phoenix is just so fucking bonkers.
Oh, for sure. Yeah.
You don't know what to take out to put this in, but it's not because All or Nothing is a bad card.
Yeah, and that was actually mostly her argument, but I think she might give it a try again. I think it has its place. In Dishonored Scorpion, I think it definitely does. I also, you know, against my better judgment, I do run Kudaka, mostly because just the air ring is a thing that we like.
Yeah. Yeah, for sure.
You know, buying her is a tough choice, but she actually does pretty well. She's like definitely one of the workhorses in the deck. So we'll see how she does against you, though. Going against Phoenix is going to be pretty rough and tough. So, but yeah, I mean, my deck has basically got a bunch of low drop characters. I go ahead and just try and, you know, withstand any pummeling from whatever fast deck I'm facing. And at some point, try and make sure that you have no more honor. What's funny is this deck, ironically, does not because it tries to, but people end up needing to like pass conflicts so that I don't get unopposed against them, that it actually ends up being sort of a deck that can break stuff, like if it really wants to. Like it doesn't try to, but it does it, right? Like circumstantially,
it's just as a side effect
happening.
Yeah. And I see you've got Fate, Wars, and Death for your restricted card. I think that's probably
I've been on that these days. I think I've been on that since it became restricted, to be honest. I might have at the EC at Saugus run Forged Edict. I'm trying to remember what deck I ran there, but I love a Fate Worse Than Death still. I think it's like the Mirror Motor Fury of Scorpion plus better.
Yeah, that's the way of putting it.
You know, so. All right, cool. We have our game set up. I have nothing else to say. I'm happy to have the chat go with you and me on this, but I'm also happy to just me talk, and you can hop off, and you can go focus on all of your Tadaka plays that you need to make. But it's totally up to you. I'm up for it.
Yeah, no, I'll pop off so I can focus on playing, and we won't, you know, you can talk about your lines of play without me overhearing your strategy. But cool. I'll see you on the other side. And
yeah, we can maybe do a quick chat after if you have time. So
yeah, sounds good.
All right, thanks for coming on, buddy.
Yeah.
We'll talk soon. All right. So we're getting set up here. Looks like Ray and I are starting. We have... All right. So in this situation, I'm just going to make sure really that right now that we are all set with this call. Excuse me for one moment. Cool. We are. All right. So let me readjust here after that little chit-chat. So... I typically like to run Abandoning Honor under my box, but for the purposes of this, I am considering running Pilgrimage. In the Phoenix matchup, just simply because if I can make one Dishonor stick that can potentially get me a kill on somebody like a Tadaka. But the Abandoning Honor under the box, for those that don't know, triggers before the province fully breaks, so... you can actually just honor somebody out if you can, if they break and they have somebody dishonored and they're at one honor. So that's kind of the argument there. I guess we're going to go ahead with, you know, against my better, I'm going to stick with my guns here. We're going to go Abandoning Honor under my box. It's just what I've been doing. I'm going to stick with it. Oh, wow. Two Kadakas. This does not happen often for me. Well, that's going to be a mulligan because simply we are facing good old Phoenix. So let's mulligan those. Okay, good. I like to see this. I'm going to pop some music on for people. Let's see what we got here. Hopefully this won't be bothersome to people. I'm going to keep it a little low. Yeah, got a little gangsta stuff going here, a little bit energized. I've got no kids the past couple days. My wife and I are just home alone, so we've been having a good time playing games, getting this in before it's like bedtime, so that's awesome. So we see all nothing, backhanded combat. So these are all really good choices, actually. I have to remember Tadaka is a card, so we're going to go ahead with this, actually. I don't hate this. Actually, you know what? The backhanded is going to hold off simply because I'm not going to need it now, and I'm going to want other stuff, and that's going to be for later. And if I use that and Tadaka comes out, it's going to be a dead card. All right, he gets his one-off Kadaka here. Winning. All right, let's see. What's he gonna write? Oh yeah, I forgot he's running. He's running Atsuko. Okay, we're gonna go with our funny different mat. We do like that. Pass for fate. I'm gonna go ahead and make him lose one honor since he passed. The manipulator here for an extra card is not bad. That may seem odd, but card parity is going to be rough against Phoenix. I'm going to be bidding low next turn, probably, so we'll see how this plays out. He gets... So, display of power is offline right now. I just got to remember that. He's probably got a Shrine Maiden over there. And then against the waves. Ooh. Yeah. We're not gonna do this though. Alright, so I let him break this. Not a great... And it's not a bad thing. He won't be bowing there. But... I can also display off this. He gets a card. Doesn't bow. I get to discard a bunch of cards from his hand. I think we display a power of this. Shrine Maiden, display power. Right now, I really kind of want to get rid of this Shrine Maiden. But Supernatural is good. Against the Wave, always good. Display, he has turned on. I really think the display long-term is the right choice, even though Supernatural is also really good. I really don't want that Dreamer, so let's see if we can just find what's under there. Okay, upholding. Not too bad. Okay. So, good dishonor. Puts him at 2. Me at 1. Not great. He's going to bring that Shrine Maiden in. Uh, Charmin's what? Zero, yeah. Zero glory. Huh. He's got... You know, I could probably win this because he's got the two against the waves. The one against the waves. But I have the two for shames. The trade on that's pretty interesting. I think I do that, actually. We're going to go ahead and do this. He will against the waves. And then I just do it again. He uses his box, which turns off the Shrine Maiden, so effectively gets what I want. Ray's awesome. Him and I have a lot of fun. He's one of the best guys on our Discord channel, for sure. Ray passes? I pass too. I'll draw a card. What did I get? Oh, I got a supernatural. Man, I like it. I like them apples. Here's that Shrine Maiden. What is she killing? Oof. Clarity of Purpose. Ooh, got rid of the Let Go. All the splashes is gone. Let's see. So he's going to come mill. I'm going to have unopposed. He's going to actually get pretty good hit on this, probably. But hey, such is life. Pass. Oh, go in the water ring. Secret cash. What do we find? Well. So this is interesting because the display now is a terrible choice. Typically, but because he's also he's gonna try and bow my fawning, and then he's gonna unbow with the against the waves and his KI box. So I actually take, ironically here, or I take the assassinate and go down to three. I actually might take the assassinate here. Let's remember what he has in his hand. He's got the consumed, a katana, and a... Right, the consumed, the against the waves, and the katana. So does he get the break on this? Probably not. If I assassinate... I think the assassinate's the right thing here. Can we hold off on the display? He's going to against waves anyways, right? So, oh no, he can't, right? I'm sorry. It cost one. So he really does need this. All right, ladies and gentlemen, we're going to get an unopposed void that's going to turn all in nothing. Really hate that dreamer, but I really can't be affording a upholding right now. Okay. Gains that fate. Doesn't really help him. Really could break, but not going to. And we're going to go ahead and resolve the air ring. Let's see. Let's go ahead and make this political. Done. And I always click this just because I don't like forgetting it. We'll go political. I mean, I'm not going to lie. That was a good turn for me, but it's against Phoenix here. Let's just be 100% honest. Like, this thing turns around on a dime. I think we keep that Righteous. We might actually buy it next turn. What's under that box? Midnight? Ooh, I think we might buy that. Let's see what we get here. And we definitely bidding one here. I'm actually going to use my box before, so he's going to get a passing fate. So that frees up my purchases a little, my purchase order a little bit. Oh my gosh, that is crazy. Just absolutely absurd. Wow. I mean, I still buy this. I expect, let's see, he's got... we do this, lose one honor. He's by something else. He's by Master Gishi Toshi. I pass. I bid one. Down to six. Not great for me. Would have loved to bid five there from him, but hey. We do have this Meek Informant, which we are going to use at some point. So he's going to Ethereal Dreamer on the Earth. Sorry, on the Air Ring, I expect. I might do Fire. Right. Is there anything I want to do right now? I don't think so before we get our Dreamer situation. Man, I still feel good about that turn, but I feel bad about this turn. It's just one of those things, like, Phoenix has so much good stuff. All right, so we're at, yeah, Air Ring. That seems correct. Right now, his Kudaka is, what, 4 plus 2 is 6 minus 1 is 5. So, I already used my 4 Shames, which hurt, but that really helped getting his hand down. We are going to play this Meek now, I think. So we pulled a Censure. And that Court Games. Okay. All right, so, I don't think I care about the Air Ring right now. I'm probably going to buy Righteous Magistrate out of Upholding. So, I think we go Mill. I can't go Mill right now. I have to buy something to do that, don't I? That's a rough predicament. Actually, it's not that terrible. We're going to go. So if I spend 3, put 5, 2 on there, it's 5. I have 3. if I spend 5 here, go for the Fire Ring. Actually, I go for the Water Ring. He is not running. I'm going to go ahead and hop over to his... He's not running any... Yeah. He's not running any Fish Boys. So, which I already saw his hand, so I don't know why I had to check that. I actually think we're going to buy this. I put 5. That leaves me 3 left. I go ahead. Let's do 2. This doesn't feel 100% great, but we're doing it. Do I want to give him more money? Not really. All right, so we've seen this is air, this is earth. Void is going to be one of these. Oof. Actually, I'm going to give him the money. Oh, no, I'll just go here. He could military pump me, which isn't a great thing. And I break that? Yeah, I'm not going to do that. This is probably a little bit backwards, I'll be honest. Going with the mill first, and I have two political with dashes and mill, but his mill is pretty piss poor right now. Yeah, he needs to defend, so I think he goes in with that. I mean, he's got like two against the waves minimum, right? Yeah, he's got two against the waves, so like I don't know what his concern is here. I just want to force one. That seems correct. Probably should have actually gone Earth, but I really wanted that fate. Yep. There's that katana we talked about, everybody. Which I'm okay with. I'm actually okay with. Did I want to do more? Of course. I think we let that go. I got the money. He got the money, but I'm not sure I did that right. To be perfectly honest. He's got a clarity too. I mean, he's got a pretty good setup right now. Okay. What's he pulling on this? Court games puts him at 4. He can't break. I don't think there's any way of actually breaking this. He goes to 4. Oh, he does. It's supernatural, right? Yeah. What am I talking about? I think this is the right thing here. I think I gotta go air or earth. Or void. Void is not bad. I thought it would stand the dreamer there. That's interesting. Now I have to do this. Does he have any way to pump me up? I don't think so. Oh, he can actually. He could supernatural storm me to break that. Let's not do that, Adam. Let's be smart. Mm-hmm. These are cards that exist that I can't do anything about. So, that's two clarities. I could get an unopposed air here. I don't feel like that's bad. Because he's down to four cards, so he's got his Against the Waves, Consumed, Court Games, and another Katana? Oh, man, he comes in on mill. We do it. We gotta do it. I know I can't bow, but unopposed air without display seems not bad. He's going in hard. Going in hard. Hot and heavy. I don't blame him. But I got that air ring out of the way. Coming in at 3-5. He'll break Pilgrim Mage. Nothing I can do about that. Mm-hmm. Seems correct there, Ray. Well, I don't think I have anything I can do. We just go ahead and let him take it. You know, I had my good times, and they were had. Okay, collector losing? Meh. Take it. So we're going to be a card parody because we're both losing characters that have sincerity, so we're both he'll be up by one, excuse me. Makes sense. Going for that favor. He does have a censure. Getting that assassinate when it did was not great. I mean, it's a good card for me, but I would have liked to get rid of that dreamer for this last turn. Yeah, gotta keep that. Oh my goodness. Oh, this could get cheeky with the fawning if I do this right. if he plays Ujina. Stupid Master Yi Satoshi. Not having any card draw right now is actually starting to hurt me. No way I'll be able to pull this off, that's for sure. He's got a censure online. Looking at all the rings. Man, I could have. So I was thinking about this while he's doing that. I could have bid two, but. And then he goes to five. I go to seven. I then assassinate. I then go to four. And he's at five. I could bring him back down to four. It's nothing great, but it would have given me to use my box. I really want to use my tattered missive, but, you know, he has a censure online. At least one. I don't even know if he has more than one. So now I really want. Ugh. This is a good turn for him. No question. Good turn. Midnight Rebels is in play. If I can bow that freaking Master Gisei Choshi. I would be happy. So fire, we have Master Yi Satoshi on air, and then +2/+2 on, I gotta actually ask him, as in which ring is on each. So I want to know which. It's not going to really matter because he pretty much has control over this. Is that not checking it out? Okay. Oh, so tempted to use the tattered missive right now on that diplomat. I actually want him to get to my box. This is why abandoning's over there, right? If I can get him down enough, he breaks on that with one with Kudaka. If I can get two, I need to dishonor. I need two more triggers of my box on him to get him down to two honor. Three would be okay, but he's gonna cancel one of my backhanded. So I gotta figure out. I don't think there's any way I can do it. If I can pull it, he's gonna not go void, which is interesting. Well, no, because he goes air, he kind of just wins it. So katana is fire. Okay, so he's gonna go fire here. And Midnight Rebels, if he hits that, secret cache. Ugh. This is tough. So I said, You know, that was a strong first turn, but turn two, he came out swinging, and turn three, he's got those two. Ethereal Dreamers are just such great cards. And, I mean, Master Gi Saitoshi is really the game breaker. So it's on air ring, on air, that I cannot use. Yeah. Non-spell on air. He must be cross-referencing with my deck list to see what my provinces are. Is that what you're doing, Ray? Come on, my man. You got this. I'm cheering you on, buddy. I want to win, but I want you to win, too. open deck lists are so much fun. People are so not on Abandoning Honor, and I have been on it. It's amazing. I mean, I'm sure other people are too, but I've been loving it. Oh, give me cards. Give me cards, Ray Dog. Come on, give me those cards. Of course I have a reaction. Jigoku. Okay, so I display a power. He's definitely stopping this. Which I don't care about, because I'll accept him. So he'll get the fire ring. You're coming. So he's coming in at 2, 3 plus the plus 2, right? He's coming in hot and heavy. But if I display a power and I pop somebody off, that's dishonor. I assassinate one. He's going to cancel this. He's going to cancel this. Right. He's going to cancel this. I got to remember that. He's going to cancel this. Huh. This is good stuff. This is it? Oh, actually, he's got the favor on mill too. Ooh, this is so nasty. So he breaks this regardless. I display, he cancels, and then what do we walk into? Him and I were playing this weekend, and we rolled off, and I rolled a 30 on his. He has a D30, and he was wearing a shirt that said, "I only roll 20s." I said, "Well, I'm sorry, I only roll 30s." So that's why that little inside joke there for anybody paying attention. All right, so I can totally win this ring though too, because can I? I'm getting ahead of myself here. I gotta remember. I don't know what he has. I need to go back and look. I've totally lost track of what that key has. Okay, so 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Okay, so he's got another katana. He's got the Against the Waves. Clarity of Purpose. Yeah. Okay, so I mean, I could. I don't want the cunning. Cunning doesn't buy me anything right now. I really want to run this assassinate in his face. Unopposed puts me to 7. He doesn't have any characters to bring in though, right? Yeah. I think it's actually the display. It's gonna be cost me 2 fate to do this. Oh, unless he can't. Oh, he might cancel my assassinate. Which would be cute. Alright. This is so meek of me. What do I do? Unopposed, speed of 7. Do I assassinate now? I think I do. And then he killed. Yep. Mm-hmm. Okay.
Display of power!
I kind of want to do the... I gotta do this. I have to. All right. This is wackadoo. So I'd like that, but I really think. So if he goes air on a conflict, I'm going to get screwed because I can't backhand it in the middle of him breaking upholding. So I'd have to do it before, which is scary as heck. I don't need the money, so I actually probably could go air to turn that off. Then he has to defend. Actually, I think I go air. Oh, nobody could do that. Oh, that would be brutal. Military air. I can't use any... we both can't use any spell events. Non-spell events. He display a powers me here? Is that a thing he could do? He could do that. Seems bad. I'd rather have him display the power of my void ring. Let's be honest. Oof. I pass. This is so tight. This is Razor's Edge. Yep. That's the thing. I will not get my Void Ring. This is certain. The only way I pull this off is... Do I do it? Do I look at my hand? I need one dishonor card. Let's look at my discard. I need one way of the scorpion. I've already spent one. The odds are pretty low. High roll. Let's go. Oh, and I get that. That sucks. That is the rub, ladies and gentlemen. That's a dead card. Anyways. Needed one more fate, everybody. See? I knew that. I calculated it. I didn't say it, but I was thinking about it. Can I go and do anything with this? No, because not dishonored. Can I? I could backhanded box. Put him to 3. That's actually what I think I can do. So I think I take this. I get the collector. He's got all of his stuff turned on. This is how we do it, guys. Ladies and gentlemen, this is how we lose games. I needed this void ring. We tried. I mean, we've got a cunning magistrate right now. Of course. All right. I think he wins here because he just boosts up this Master Gisei Toshi. He lost 2 court games, though, right? Is he out of court games? 1, 2. Did he have a court games? We're going to find out. Oh, I can't use court games. Ugh, that's right. So frustrating. Oh, I should have gone air. I knew it. I was like thinking about it. I mean, sure. 0 fate. Conflict. I need that shameful or mark of shame. I done screwed up, everybody. So close. I can't use my collective or anything. Nothing happens. No bueno. See, this is so close. We abandoning honor onto this. Need a one, two more. Pause the music and see if he wants to come back in here.
Hello.
Hey, buddy. That was awesome.
Oh, that was fucking wild, dude.
I know. So, this is... So, I literally was like, okay, if I don't go air here and on my conflict and yeah. and I don't win, then you win. Because, honestly, I figured... So, I was like, oh, I just need... If I won that... void ring, I had another all and nothing in my hand. So right. I void into an air ring. I had those two backhanded, but that your stupid what was it, the shrine maiden with the freaking katana?
Yeah, the hero of the game.
She was. I was making fun of her the whole time, and she was the hero. Well, because it was annoying too. Because I was like, oh, I should go air, which I think you saw. I had it clicked probably.
Yeah.
And I was like, I have to go air just so that when you swing on my box, I can use all my cards. And then at the very end, I go, oh, dum-dum here. Oh, let me use court games and dishonor your master, Gisei Toshi. Wait, that's not a spell event.
Yeah.
Like, I was like, oh, at least I can get through that. But no, that, so I said it during the game. I didn't say it before, but like, that's why I put abandoning honor on the box because people get down to one honor and they are going to break. And then you blow up my abandoning honor and then I kill you and then you lose the game before the box breaks.
Right. You can definitely sneak out a win that way. Like,
and usually,
you were one backhanded compliment away from
totally.
That to me.
Yeah. The realization I had, which I actually has not come up for me at all yet, was that I could backhand myself into my own City of the Open Hand. It just hasn't been a situation where I could do that. I was like, oh, this is the same as me backhanding him, but I get the card. You know?
Yeah. If you really need the card draw.
Yeah. Which, so all I wanted on that. So I'm going to actually look right now. All I wanted, what I was looking for, the reason I went high roll there with the
tattered... Yeah, I saw the tattered missile.
Yeah, I wanted one way at the scorpion.
Okay.
And it was nowhere near. I had only used one. Yeah. I had 23 cards left, and I was like, okay, odds are like, you know, 15%.
Still two in there.
Yeah, they're still in there. The last one was at the very bottom. The other one was oh, no, I forgot. You know what? I'm an idiot. I forgot. I changed for this for the deck for the league. I changed it to two, so I totally miscalculated that because I switched. I switched to two and put my duty back in. So that was my own stupidity, forgetting that I went down to two. Ugh, I'm dumb. But no, that was so much fun. That first turn, I literally said at the end, if you rewatch the video, I was like, "That was a really good turn." Guess what? It's it's not gonna go that well the next couple of turns. That first turn, I was like, "Yeah, that was." I was like. I think I had four rings on the first turn, something like that.
Yeah, you took all the rings. I ran into holding authority, so you took my display of power, which was, I didn't see another one for the whole game.
Yeah, and that was my thought, like, throughout the whole game, I was just like, oh my gosh. Like, I said at the beginning, I was like, I know this isn't good for now, but I'm like, this is future-proofing, because I said it on the recording, I'm like, I am going to definitely bid low the next turn, so... If you, and assuming you would, thinking, and you did, you bid two. So I'm like, well, now, and then I had a meek informant. So I was like, okay, this gives me the all the information I need to know if he ever has another one for the majority of the game. So,
right.
No, that was super tight. Like, the all or nothing, man. I told you, you saw that played out. That was great, huh?
Yeah. No, that was awesome. And like, you know, it made the void ring so much more threatening, both to either try and take, because you might display and then all or nothing.
Yeah.
It made me like when I saw you coming in void ring, I was like, okay, I have to defend this. The only reason I was comfortable doing it with Shrine Maiden was because I knew you'd already played the assassinate.
Yeah, definitely.
So I was home free there.
So the only reason I played my assassinate was to pull out your censure so I could display a power you.
I see. Okay.
Yeah. Cause I figured, I was like, okay, I'm going to lose secret cash either way. And I figured unopposed is okay. And then I figured if I assassinate, you cancel it. If you don't, you break, and now I actually think if you had not canceled it, you were even better off, because now I display, and you just like, okay, you have basically no chance of losing on Dishonored, because I didn't get another guy off the board. You know, I didn't get another guy Dishonored because of the fire ring.
You wouldn't have been able to display the ring, as it would have just bounced back, because nobody would have been in the
Oh, right, if I had killed. Yeah, that's right, you had no other characters in your hand. That's right, I did double check that. You had no other characters in your hand. That's right. That's true. So it would have been kind of a bounce back. So I guess it was a win-win for me either way. Well, win-win, but... Yeah, you're right. I guess your way was right, more correct, because that gave you a chance to now hit my box, so...
Right, because I was like, if I don't win this turn, the pressure is on such that I don't live through the next turn.
Yeah, if I go first, so, it's like you're in a tough situation.
Right, if we start a turn and I'm at like 3 honor, it's no bueno. Because I was going to lose, at least the Kudaka was dishonored.
Yep.
And, you know, you dishonored the Dreamer. So I was just like, there's no way that I can survive next turn. I need to break now or I don't break.
Totally, yeah, totally. Yeah, the fact that you thought it was Midnight Revels, I was like, that's awesome.
Yeah. Yeah, man.
There was a good the beginning of the game. I don't know if you remember. I was sitting there and I was talking. I was like,
yeah, I saw you taking a long time to pick your stronghold.
Yeah, because I was saying, just because I wanted to kind of like give people my two senses. I do often put abandoning there, but in this situation, if I hit Tadaka, if you hit Tadaka, and I have abandoning on the row, and you hit that, that's a better play. So
right,
and I can kill your Tadaka. So that's one of those weird things. I was like, you know what, I made the choice to go with what I feel more comfortable with, knowing that I could get lucky with your Tadaka hitting my, or somebody hitting my abandoning in the row with Tadaka dishonored, which is not, you know, like that's luck, I think, a little bit more.
Yeah,
whereas this is like, you're coming in hot because you know you have to break. If you don't break, you lose, but then when you break, you might die.
Before that really puts the pressure on you to try and like squeeze out every drop of honor before it gets to that point.
Yeah, if I had a Mark of Shame, it would have been a big deal too, because like I couldn't use any spell events, but if I could have Mark of Shamed like your Master Guiche, I also had a Bayushi Collector, so if I had no way to get my Cunning Magistrate dishonored, and I'd have the Fate, but I was like, ah, that cloud was huge for some reason.
Yeah, the cloud was definitely clutch.
Yeah, because you would have been at, it would have been 4-2, right? You didn't have any. Only a pump you had was
a
supernatural.
Yeah, Superstorm.
Yeah, yeah. And you had one in your discard too.
And then I could do one from the box.
Yeah, I knew. That's why I said I knew I lost once I didn't hit the air. Once I did not win on the void to trigger my all and nothing.
Right.
I knew I basically lost. So it was.
Yeah, that was like the real fight was over the void ring there.
Yeah, for sure. No, that was a lot of fun though. So I'm gonna actually stop. I'm gonna stop our recording. Everybody that listened and watched, you know, we're obviously on YouTube, which is probably where you're watching this, but we also have Twitch. Ray, you're on Dice or Death, right? YouTube and Twitch.
Yeah, YouTube and Twitch. I don't have a cool URL because I don't have enough subscribers, but.
But you will soon. You should.
I will. So search for Dice or Death, and you'll find some NEL5R like group stage games that I casted there. So
nice. And you usually stream on Twitch on like Fridays, right? You kind of get games.
Yeah, that's what I've been doing. I haven't recently because we're in the middle of moving to a new house.
Oh yeah,
and
congrats.
Everything is super discombobulated. But once we get into the new place and I can kind of get a new streaming setup, I'm gonna be back on the beat. So
nice. Yeah. Cool. Well, I just want to make sure I thank our patrons again. We have quite a few. We have obviously Luxury Playstyle, Lux Informant, for 15% off, and then Midgard Games out of Derry, New Hampshire. They are graciously sponsoring us as well. And we have a third Patreon as well. And so we'll hopefully have some more as we continue. We just started it. It's patreon.com/meekinformant. If you like what we do, think about subscribing. And if you're not interested in L5R, I don't know why you watch this, but we also have a board game channel, which is called Board Game Informant. And that's all through the same Patreon. So hopefully we see you guys around in the future. And if you enjoyed watching this stuff, you know, thumbs up, all that good stuff. Like, subscribe, share, yada, yada, yada. See you later. Good night.
Bye.
Bye.